sahano vavato, sahano bhunakto, sahavidyam karavavahai, tejasvinavadhitamastu ma vidvishavahai. Om shanti shanti shanti. Sadashiva samarambham Shankaracharya madhyamam Asmadacharya paryantam Vande guru paramparam Shruti smriti purananam Alayam karunalayam Namami bhagavat pada Shankaram loka shankaram Shankaram shankaracharyam Keshavam badarayanam Sutra bhashya krutau vande Bhagavantau punah punah Samasta jana kalyani Niratam karunamayam Namami Chinmayam Devam Sadgurum Brahma Vidvaram Sadgurum Brahma Vidvaram Om Namo Narayanaya chant the first three shlokas. Tatjnanam prashamakaram yadindriyanam tatjneyam yadupanishatsu nischitartham te dhanya bhuvi paramartha nischiteha Sheshastu Brahmanilaye Paribhramantaha. Once again. Tatjnanam prashamakaram yadindriyanam Tatjneyam yadupanishatsu nischitartham Bhuvi paramartha nischiteha Sheshastu Brahmanilaye Paribhramantaha Adau Vijit nitya vishayan madamoharaga dveshadi shatruganamahruta yoga rajyah jnatva matam samanubhuya paratma vidya kanta sukham vanagrihe. Once again, adau vijitya vishayan madamoharaga dveshadi shatruganamahruta yoga rajyah jnatva matam samanubhuya paratma vidya kanta sukham vanagrihe vicharanti dhanyah tyaktva grihe rati madhogati hetu bhutam atmechayopanishadartharasam pibantah vitaspruha vishaya bhogapade viraktah dhanyascharanti vijaneshu viraktasangah tyaktva grihe rati madhogati hetu bhutam atmechayopanishadartharasam pibantah vitaspruha vishaya bhogapade viraktah dhanyascharanti vijaneshu viraktasangah. What is a sign of knowledge? Tat jnanam prashamakaram yedindriyanam. That which quietens the mind and the senses, that alone can be called as knowledge. So the proof of knowledge is peace of mind. This is what the Upanishads say. And who are the blessed ones? Blessed ones are those who strive in this direction. Te dhanya bhuvi paramartha nishchita ihah. What about others who are striving to find happiness in the outer world, roaming around in the outer world, trying to get this or that? Sheshastu brahmanilaye paribhramanta. They are just completely deluded, wandering in the world of delusion. Okay, so peace of mind, quietude of mind and the senses is the goal. What is that which disturbs the mind? Adau vijitya vishayan madamoharaga dveshadi shatruganam. So there are certain enemies which disturbs the peace of mind. Who are those enemies? Kama krodha lobha moha madamatsirya. How are these enemies gaining their strength in the mind, gaining their root? Vishayan. When we unintelligently interact with the vishayas, the sense objects, then the mind becomes filled with all these negativities. So therefore, if one has to win over this yoga of the kingdom of yoga, if we have to conquer this mind, then we will have to conquer these negativities. And thus, that is possible only when we make our interaction with the sense objects intelligent. Sense objects are not the problem. Our unintelligent interaction with the sense objects, that unintelligent interaction is the problem. So how to take care of that? So therefore, point number one, so in the verse 3, Bhagavan says, tyaktva grihe ratim adhogati hetu bhutam. One such place where we unintelligently interact with the world is nothing but our own home. Griheratim, unintelligent interaction starts from our own home. Unhealthy attachment with our own home, the members of our home, relatives. Griheratim, this attachment, that can cause all these negativities. And these negativities will in turn disturb your mind. So therefore, even when we are living in our family, in our own home, ensure that your interaction is healthy. So in the last class, we had seen six limitations of worldly life. All these six limitations should be kept in mind. Limitation of worldly knowledge, limitation of worldly wealth, then limitation of worldly pleasures, then limitation of worldly existence, then limitation of worldly love, and then limitation of worldly relationship. So these are the ways in which we mess up our family life. And thus, we think that the family life is the problem. No, no, no. Tyaktva griham, it is not said. Tyaktva grihe ratim is said. So this rati, unhealthy attachment, is the problem. World is never a problem. It is always our unhealthy interaction with the world which is a problem. Okay. So that is one place which can cause disturbance in the mind. Okay. Now next one is presented in the next verse, verse number 4, page number 15. Repeat once. Tyaktva mamahamiti bandhakare pade dve. Tyaktva mamahamiti bandhakare pade dve. Manavamana sadrusha samadarshinascha. Manavamana sadrusha samadarshinascha. Kartaramanyamavagamya tadarpitani. Kartaramanyamavagamya tadarpitani. Kurvanti karma paripaka phalani dhanyah. Kurvanti karma paripaka phalani dhanyah. Tyaktva mamahamiti bandhakare pade dve. Manavamana sadrusha samadarshinascha. Kartaramanyamavagamya tadarpitani. Kurvanti karma paripaka phalani dhanya. Once again. Tyaktva mamahamiti bandhakare pade dve. Manavamana sadrusha samadarshinascha. Kartaramanyamavagamya tadarpitani. kurvanti karma paripaka phalani dhanyah. Yes. So what is another aspect which we have to take care if we have to quieten the mind? That another aspect is mama aham. Ahankara and mamakara. This is another thing which will disturb your mind. So what has to be done? Tyaktva. Mama aham iti. Why should we give it up? Tyaktva means to give up. Why should we give up ahankara and mamakara? Because bandhakare pade dve. They are bandhakaram. Karam means that which causes. Bandhakaram means that which causes bandhanam, bondage. Ahankara and mamakara will bind you. This is called a psychological bondage. So what is psychological bondage? Which will helplessly make you get disturbed. That is called as bondage. Bondage means there is lack of freedom. Lack of freedom is called bondage. Helplessness is called bondage. So helplessly you will worry. Helplessly you will get tensed up. Anxious. That helplessness is called bondage. Ahankara mamakara will cause this psychological bondage. Generally we think ahankara is not bandhakara but sukhakara. People who superficially analyze life, they think ahankara is sukhakara. Whenever I am praised, I am happy. So therefore, I must expand my I, so that there is more and more cause of praise, recognition, respect from the society. Bigger the aham, greater is the respect which I get from the society. So therefore, greater the respect I get, greater is my joy. Therefore, bigger the aham, greater the joy. This is our equation. Now, how to expand aham? Aham can be expanded by expanding mama. Mamakara is the way to expand ahankara. That which I possess is called mamakara. So, aham can be expanded by expanding the mamakara. By expanding the possession, expanding the position, expanding the influence. These are all coming under mamakara. Mamakara means mine. That which belongs to me. Possession, position, influence, power, glory, fame. They're all coming under mamakara. Abilities, talents. So therefore, unintelligently analyzing life and coming to this conclusion that expansion of aham is sukhakara, we expand aham by expanding mama. This is what we find in the society. But unfortunately, the more and more ahankara expands, there is more and more sorrow alone. Understand this fact. Expansion of ahankara is not joy, it is only sorrow. Greater the ahankara, greater will be the disturbance of mind. They are directly connected. Because ahankara takes root in ignorance. Ahankara takes root in absence of knowledge. So therefore, the more and more a person's ahankara is stronger, more and more further away he is from knowledge. Knowledge is light. So therefore going away from knowledge means going towards darkness, going towards ignorance. Knowledge is peace. So going away from knowledge means what? Going away from peace. Going away from peace means getting more and more disturbed. The more and more ahankara we have, the more and more we'll be troubled by kama, krodha, lobha, moha, mada, matsarya. The more and more we puncture this ego, our mind will be peaceful. We'll not be disturbed by any of these things. Now this is a very practical tip. The moment ahankara comes, ahankara means I. That very moment you are separated from the totality. Vyashti gets separated from samashti. The individual gets separated from the total with this boundary line called ego. Ego is the wheel. The moment I get separated from the totality, I and mine, you and yours, this division comes. And what happens when this division comes? Mana avamana sadrushaha samadarshinascha. Mana avamana comes. Mana means what? Superiority complex. Avamana means what? Inferiority complex. Apamana means actually insult. But what is this insult? Inferiority complex. When I have more than others, I have the superiority complex. When I have less than others, then I have this inferiority complex. Both of them are nothing but disturbance of the mind. One is the crest of the wave, the other is the trough of the wave. The higher and the lower. Wherever higher is there, lower is there. So there is superiority complex, there is inferiority complex, there is comparison, there is jealousy. Then there is striving hard to defeat others, compete with others. All these are called disturbance. Varieties of disturbances. So all these disturbances are born out of ego. And again there is an illusion that if I have more than others, I will be happy. I should ever be ahead of others. These are all different illusions born out of the fundamental illusion called ego. Ego will create multiple layered illusions. So what should a spiritual seeker do? End this primary illusion born out of ignorance. Don't try to fulfill other illusions. This is what wise people do. They don't try to find a solution at the superficial level. They try to find solution foundation level. The foundation of all illusion is ego. So destroy that. If avankara mamakara is gone, then what will happen? Mana avamana sadrushaha. Mana and avamana will create no disturbance in your mind. Samadarshinah. That person becomes samadarshi. Man of equal vision. Samadarshi. What is samadarshanam? We are all one. At the body level, we are all perishables. At the consciousness level, we are all imperishable, one entity. This is called samadarshanam. And we are all striving to gain this state. But Bhagavan, how to put it into practice? Karma yoga is the way. Kartaram anyam avagamya tad arpitani kurvanti. Dhanyaha kurvanti. So how to get rid of this ego? Get rid of this kartrutva bhava. There's a practical tip given. The practical tip, even while living in the world, how to end this ego. Kartaram anyam avagamya. Understand avagamya. What? Kartaram anyam. Considering that the doer is somebody different. So who is the different one? The Lord. Bhagavan himself is the doer. Iti avagamya. Thus understanding. Dhanyaha kuruvanti. Tad arpitani kuruvanti. Karma phalani. Tad arpitani kuruvanti. So this is nothing but the essence of karma yoga. Performing action as a worship of the Lord. With this understanding that Bhagavan himself is the doer. Everything belongs to Bhagavan. Therefore, action must belong to Bhagavan. All my abilities and talents belong to Bhagavan. Possessions and position belong to Bhagavan. If with this attitude we perform action, then what are we doing? We are not allowing the ego to take root. Whatever I have, everything belongs to Bhagavan. Whatever others have, that also belongs to Bhagavan. In this way, if we can perform action. So here, escaping from action is not prescribed. Escaping from the world is not prescribed. Escaping from the action is not prescribed, because that is not the solution. The solution is living in the world, performing the duties in the world. As and when we perform these duties, performing it with the right attitude, right understanding. That is what is important. Taking sannyasa will not help. Running away from the world and burying yourself in some cave will not help. Learn to live in this world. Face the challenges of this world. Be in the marketplace. Go through all the ups and downs of the world. But in the process, do it with the right attitude. Action is never the problem. Wrong understanding behind action is the problem. Wrong attitude behind performance of action is the problem. So therefore, correct this attitude. Correct this understanding. Once that is done, then world is never a problem. World is a beautiful place. So, kartaram anyam avagamyam. Understanding that doer is somebody different. Bhagavan is the doer. Tat arpitani. Offering all your actions unto him. Dhanyaha karma paripaka phalani. So whenever actions are done, results will come. So what should we do with those results? There should not be any enjoyership, bhoktrutva. So escape from kartrutva and bhoktrutva. I did it, therefore I enjoy. This attitude should go away. So what should be your attitude when the results come? Bhagavan, it is your grace, it is your blessing, it is your prasad. So the four principles of karma yoga, what are they? Kartavya nirvahanam, performance of duties. Number two, Samyak Acharanam, doing it as best as you can. Number three, Ishvara Arpana Buddhi. Ishvara Arpana Buddhihi, performing it as a worship of the Lord. Fourth one, Ishvara Prasada Buddhi. That is what is said here. So Dhanyaha, the blessed ones, live in this way. Not allowing Ahankara and Mamakara to fructify. Rather, Ahankara and Mamakara should die with karma. Then that is karma yoga. If Ahankara and Mamakara is increasing with karma, that is not karma yoga. That will only bind us. Karma Yoga should efface Ahankara Mamakara. In that case, you can directly see it. How do I know my Ahankara Mamakara is increasing or decreasing? Mind becomes more and more peaceful. Tatnyanam Prashamakaram Yatindriyanam. The whole Dhanyashtakam is revolving around that one line. Tatnyanam Prashamakaram. So rate your spiritual progress with the intensity of peace which you experience. Right. Another danger which can create disturbance in the mind is pointed out in the next verse. We will see it in the next class. Om Sarve Bhavantu Sukhinaha. Sarve Santu Niramayaha. Sarve Bhadrani Pashyantu. Ma Kaschid Dukha Bhag Bhavet. Asato Ma Sadgamaya. Tamaso Ma Jyotirgamaya. Mrityurma Amritam Gamaya. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam. Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamevavashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi. Harihi Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Harihi Om.